financial analyst says the investment landscape in the Philippines this year may not be all that rosy. Fritz Ocampo of BDO says that while 2024 is perceived to be a better year for the investing public thanks to declining inflation and expected cuts in monetary policies, there remain threats to the economy such as the high cost of rice and oil.
It's actually more positive than the past 2 years. Number one, we're expecting inflation to ease this year, and that would give the BSP room to cut interest rates, number two. And then number three, when you look at the current account deficit, it's already narrowing compared to 2 years ago. And when you have those three factors, foreign investors tend to look at the Philippines with a keener eye. That starts the year on a positive tone. However, it won't be all that rosy, okay? The reason why investors and even the BSP is focused on inflation is the price of rice and the price of oil will continue to hover over our economy.
The International Monetary Fund raised its forecast for global growth this year on better-than-expected expansion in the U.S. and fiscal stimulus in China. It expects the world economy to grow 3.1%, that's up from 2.9% estimate last October, while it kept its 2025 forecast unchanged. It notes tighter central bank policy to fight inflation, plus government spending cuts in several countries are among the key reasons why growth is expected to be slower than in the two decades before the pandemic when it averaged 3.8%. Now, other downsides, as cited by the fund, the new commodity price spikes from geopolitical shocks and global supply disruptions, or a stickier inflation that could force central banks to keep rates much higher for longer. Budget carrier Cebu Pacific finalizing an order of up to 150 narrow-body jets in what could be the Philippines' largest aircraft commitment. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
Cebu Pacific announces it is now reviewing proposals sent by Airbus and Boeing for a 150-aircraft deal, the largest single-plane order in the country. The deal is projected to cost $12 to $18 billion based on catalog prices of the original equipment manufacturer or OEM.
We hope to complete that process by the first half of this year. We're looking at both OEMs and clearly made the best outfit win.
Cebu Pacific, which uses mostly Airbus planes, is looking to diversify its fleet amid rising passenger demand. Lau says previously they would buy around 30 aircraft in a single order, but now they believe it's time to invest more because of the growth prospect of the Philippine economy.
There are a lot more infrastructure opportunities. No? So whether it's the privatization of NAIA that's coming soon or the opening of Bulacan in 2026 or 2027, no? Those are huge opportunities for us. No? And clearly, parang ordering maybe 10, 15 aircraft will not be sufficient to take on those opportunities.
Even without the new order, 14 new aircraft are expected to arrive this year, which will help the airline in the supply chain issues connected to the Pratt & Whitney engine repair. The airline also said it is not prioritizing the opening of new destinations this year, but may connect existing stations or utilize bigger planes.
Connecting more dots, making existing routes thicker, right? Reviewing bases, so we talked about Katiklan earlier, we also talked about Bohol.
We try to make our operations as efficient as possible. We try to increase the utilization of our aircraft. We try to, make our flight routes more efficient.
The airline has signed a damp lease agreement with two aircraft from Bulgaria Air due to the budget carrier's limited fleet today. The damp lease deal will last for at least 4 months. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The BIR is exempting from the value-added tax 21 medicines for cancer, diabetes, hypertension, kidney disease, mental illness, and tuberculosis. Again, 21 medicines are now exempted from the VAT. Okay, this is an update to the list of VAT-exempt drugs and medicines as amended by the TRAIN Law and CREATE Acts. All right. So there's actually a list of medicines, so hopefully we can post that list on our website. The government is urged to prioritize support for the local fishing industry to ensure food security in the Philippines. Lady Vicencio reports.
At 9 years old, Ruben Aruta's daughter only stands at 3 feet and weighs 20 kilograms. Fishing is the family's only source of income, and Ruben admits his family only gets what is left from a day's catch, which is not enough.
Kung ano nga mauhuli, bisogo, kung ano, lapu-lapo, iba binibenda.
A study by the Department of Science and Technology Food and Nutrition Research Institute showed that children from households relying on fish for a living have the highest malnutrition prevalence compared to non-fishing families. One in every five infants and toddlers age five are underweight, while 3 out of 10 kids in the same age group are stunted. For the age group of 5 and above until 10 years old, 3 out of 10 kids are underweight and stunted. Poverty and lack of access to affordable food are factors being related to malnutrition among kids from the fishing sector.
Ironically, you know, anyan din ang sinasabi nila, kami yung nagpo-provide but kami yung pinakamahirap, kami have the most malnourished children. Because ang high value, yung maayos na isda, yan ang binibenta at ano yung tira-tira.
With the lack of quality food on the table, children are at risk of developing micronutrient deficiency and may exhibit drowsiness, fatigue, and low intelligence quotient. Experts advise increasing intake of seafood rich in micronutrients needed for mental development, such as iron, iodine, and vitamin A. While milkfish and tilapia are the most commonly consumed types of fish because of affordability, wild catch fishes such as mackerel, tuna, tulingan, and round skad offer more nutritional value.
Mas mataas po ang mga nutritional value in terms of calcium, omega-3, polyunsaturated fatty acids, iron, vitamin A, and other micronutrients. They are less affordable, mas expensive if you compared yung lapu-lapo, isang kilo ng lapu-lapo, which is about 320 per kilo as compared to 160 per kilo of tilapia. Or bangus, sorry, bangus, tilapia is 120 kilograms per. But then, we need to consider also the nutritional value, specifically for the omega-6 fatty acid, which is good for the heart.
For the National Nutrition Council, behavioral change is also needed for families to favor nutrient-dense food.
To all the mothers out there, everyone, start your children to be nourished with food that are healthy, nutritious. And what are these? Rich in proteins, carbohydrates, iodine. I say, aside from being, iodine is also makes us, you know, higher IQ, have higher IQ points.
Senator Cynthia Villar and the Department of Interior and Local Government agree it is high time to make the fishing sector a priority amid threats to food security.
According to study, dati ang fish from the wild catch is 70% of our fish. Ngayon 46% na lang. Aquaculture is overtaking the wild catch in terms of producing the fish for our people. So may problema tayo talaga sa ocean.
Government units considered to be coastal. Please remember that your strength for your or the backbone for your growth is the water, your municipal waters. You will never go wrong if you will put primacy to coastal resource management, to abundance of fish preservation.
DOST FNRI recommends a whole-of-nation approach in optimizing seafood supply through decreasing wastage and empowering municipal fishers to improve hunger and poverty rate in coastal communities. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government working on some 135 water projects to secure water supply in the country amid the threat of the El Nino phenomenon. The Environment Department says it mapped rivers and streams in the country which will become the sources of water for local governments and communities. The agency is expecting 100 more projects in the coming months. The country's State Weather Bureau earlier warned that a strong El Nino phenomenon may persist until February. It also expects the majority of the country will experience below normal rainfall until April this year. The Philippine Economic Zone Authority and the country's Corrections Bureau agreed to set up so-called mega economic zones in idle penal colonies. The lands will comprise of 25,000 hectares in Palawan, 7,000 hectares in Sablayan, Mindoro, and 300 hectares in the National Penitentiary in Muntinlupa City. Among the industries eyed for the eco-zones are agriculture, renewable energy, and light manufacturing. This comes after the Bucor released hundreds of inmates to decongest its prisons nationwide. More companies now preferring hybrid work setups over work-from-home arrangements as firms try to balance the preference of job seekers and their own productivity goals. This is according to online job marketplace JobStreet by Seek. It says this trend is not just seen in the Philippines, but also across the region as economies move forward from the COVID-19 pandemic.
But our anticipation is this year, more hybrid options are going to come into play, and Filipinos are slowly also becoming more receptive to hybrid work. They are searching for work from home, but we are also seeing a lot more matches with hybrid work as well, because it's a convergence point, ika nga, no, for both our hirers as well as our Filipino job seekers.
JobStreet by Seek adds the volume of hiring firms on the platform in 2023 more than doubled from pre-pandemic times, and it expects this strong momentum to continue in the first half of this year. According to its study, 61% of employers are confident that the job market will be more active this year, while 71% of them plan to increase the headcount of permanent employees. Filipinos can now get a Greek residency and even citizenship through the Golden Visa program. Golden Visa is a residency by investment program that allows individuals and their families to obtain foreign residency or citizenship by meeting a minimum investment requirement. But brace for the price, you will need at least 250,000 euros or 15 million pesos to qualify for the program. Those who would want to stay in more popular areas in Greece like Athens and Santorini, well, they'd need to shell out about 500,000 euros or a staggering 30 million pesos. By obtaining a golden visa, the holder also gains visa-free access to 27 other European countries. The Greek Golden Visa Program, which began in 2013, granted 31,000 golden visas in 2022, contributing 2.6 billion pounds into the Greek economy. Euros, rather. The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office admits it has yet to acquire the services of a third-party international auditor to ensure the game's integrity. But the PCSO says it has ISO certifications for its game's processes and a representative of the Commission on Audit regularly observing its operations. But House lawmaker Joey Salceda asserts the ISO and COA do not guarantee the game's integrity. ISO is an international non-government organization for technical standards that member organizations agree to adopt. The PCSO has been under scrutiny following the consecutive winners of its big lottery games.